maybe a tiny little bit of spice, if any, in it. Yeah. I'm not detecting any kind of pumpkin spice in that at all. It tastes like generic lager beer. I mean, decent lager beer. It doesn't taste like your really generic lager beer that you get, like, from, like, say, Yingling or Coors or, you know, the big beer companies that just takes really, like, if you want generic beer, go drink that shit. So, yeah, this just tastes like generic lager beer and with no spice in it. So, hey, these guys are pretty good. That's not bad. Better than the beer. Oh, darn, I missed my 15-minute mark. I was trying to keep an eye on the time for YouTube, so I'm gonna have to cut these up. So yeah, not really a fan of any of these. I mean, if I had to support one and call a winner, I would just call this the winner because, like I said, they have a really good wheat beer. So, but nothing really doing for their Oktoberfest, Mars, and the rest, just really generic stuff. Not a whole lot to it. So, let me get these out of the way. Sweet, Charlie Parker and Miles Davis with Yardbird Suit. Okay, let's continue. I think we got one Oktoberfest left. This is the Smutty Nose Pumpkin Ale. And the rest are just some stuff that I've had, you know, in my fridge for the last, since the fall. We got, this is from Christmas. I think I got this from my brother for Christmas. He won't mind if I have one. this is Santa's Private Reserve from Rogue Ales. This is from Sam Adams, the more limited stuff releases that they do. This is Wee Heavy Ale. Yeah, talk about heavy. 10% alcohol volume. Wee Heavy Imperial. What kind of beer is this? This is a Scotch Ale from Sam Adams. And let's see what else. Well, I got two from each of Sam Adams, and then we got two of these from, this is Pay the Ferryman Porter from, what company is this? It's from Mexico, actually, a Mexican beer, interesting. Severa de los Muertos. What company is this by? Day of the Dead Beer. Brewed and bottled by Severia Mexicana. It's basically a Mexican brewery that it's from. So, Porter. Pay the Ferryman Porter. Alright, let's give these a try. Jazz right there from to legend as Davis. And we got an ad. Yeah, I have the free version of Spotify. So let's lay it on thick, colorful, you know, I'm not going to be sitting around all that much listening.
Hey, Kevin.
It's my brother in the background. Let's do this. Spring into savings for 3 bags of Scott's Earth Row Color Match for just $10. More saving, more doing. That's the power of the Home Depot. While supplies last, selection varies by store. U.S. only. Nice. Louis Armstrong, cheek to cheek. Oh, what movie was that from? Out to Sea. Yeah, it was from Out to Sea with Walter Matthau and Jack Lemmon. Really great movie. The last movie that they did together. Basically, it was them doing their whole grumpy old men routine. But it wasn't a grumpy old men movie, surprisingly. Hey.
Hi. How are you?
Yeah, go right ahead. I am filming for YouTube, so.
Oh, that's cool.
So. Wait, tell the people what you think. Can you taste the pineapple? Yeah, he's having one of Rivertown pineapple ale. All right, you can go.
I can't tell if it's like refreshing here or if like after a couple of months they would grow.
It's definitely got that summer feel to it.
Yeah.
Yeah. See ya. Anyway, this is the Smutty Nose Pumpkin Ale. I'm gonna bet that, you know, this, there's not gonna be much to this. Yep, I was right. I think I'm over Pumpkin Ale. I'm not even gonna bother this year. Oh, yeah, a little in the back of the throat. It's very faint pumpkin ale. Not a lot to it. Yeah, I think pumpkin ale, yeah, I think for me it's run its course, because I haven't found one that I've been, you know, like, oh, I have to get this every year. I mean, there's been, you know, some pumpkin ales that actually have taste like pumpkin and whatnot and are done, but there's not that pumpkin ale that I found that would be like, oh, I have to get this every, you know, every fall. It just hasn't happened, and, you know, I'm not going to bother, you know, buying it anymore. Unless I find something like, you know, something really unique sounding and whatnot. I'm sure I'll come across something this fall that will catch my interest, but I'm not buying, you know, a shit ton of pumpkin ales to try like I did last year. Because this, like I said, all this stuff tastes the same. It tastes like really generic beer with maybe a little bit of spice added to it. People just, you know, I'm sure these breweries just do this because it's the time of the year for pumpkin ale, so they just want to capitalize on the season. That's all there is to it. Moving on to the Christmas style beers. This is the Santa's Reserve from Rogue Ales. Oh, it's Ella Fitzgerald singing. Nice. This is pretty good. Not too terrible. But I don't enjoy it half as much as dancing cheek to cheek. Come on and dance with me. I want my arm. Yeah, that's not too shabby. What's the proof on that? I don't say. Reddish copper, yeah. It's got that red ale taste to it. Reddish copper in color with a roasty malt flavor. Yeah, a lot of malt and hoppy, sprucey finish. Yeah, definitely. This is good stuff. Okay, this is the Wee Heavy Scotch Ale from Sam Adams, their Imperial Series. Oh, this is 10% alcohol by volume 1. Yep. Oh, yeah, that's heavy from the alcohol. Getting a nice warm feeling. This is really gonna warm me up. This is some strong stuff right here. Oh, that's just all malt. That's very malty. Sam Adams Wee Heavy, inspired by the traditional Scotch ales, has a deep, intense flavor from its dark, roasted malts. The addition of peat smoked malt adds a unique flavor of the Highlands to this complex brew. Yeah, see, that's something that I don't really like when it comes to beer. I don't like beers that have a lot going on in them, and this is kind of in that kind of beer that I'm not sure if I'm really a fan of. When it's just got so much complexity to it, I don't know if I like it or if I don't like it. This is Art Tatum, Smoke Gets in Your Eyes. Yeah, I don't really like this, and I don't know if I'm even going to be able to finish the little sample of it, which is pathetic. So, let me try. That is very malty. It's like, it's all malt. A lot of malt complexity going on with that one. So, I'm gonna toss this one out. Yeah, not really a fan of really high complex style beers. And I'm more on the, I like more hop to my beer than malt. If they're really malty, I'm not really a fan. It's kind of the reason probably why I'm not a fan of chocolate beer either, because, you know, it's, you know, more on the malty side of things than the hoppy side of things. Which is funny, because I never really liked, you know, like pale ale or Indian pale ale or, you know, those kind of really hoppy beers for like the longest time, and then don't really know what beer it was, but, you know, eventually I just, you know, I came around to them, and, you know, they're stuff I really enjoy. You know, I really enjoy the hoppy side of things when it comes to beer and whatnot. So, let's continue on. This is the Pay the Ferryman Porter from that Mexican brewery. Let's give this a try. This tastes like generic porter. Nothing really to it. Not very unique. At least I could finish that one, as opposed to this stuff. Yeah, just your generic porter, but kind of cool to see that, you know, that Mexico actually is doing, you know, craft beer, you know, and porters and whatnot, because, you know, when you think Mexican beer, you think of, like, Dos Equis, or Corona. Those are the two Mexican beers I can think of off the top of my head, but, yeah, so if I had to pick a winner, it would probably be this really good red style red ale, and Rogue is some pretty good stuff and whatnot. Oh god, I'm Starting to feel drunk.